Hello, YouTubers! Today in this video, we are going to be talking about episodes 6 and 7 of The White Princess. So if you've not seen episodes 6 and 7, there will be spoilers in here. If you don't want to be spoiled by that and you've not seen them, leave now because, like I said, there's going to be spoilers! So episode 6 starts off with essentially what happened in the last episode 5 when all the traitors were being rounded up and whatnot for pledging to the fake Richard, for quotes around that, and they were being beheaded. Of course, like I said, Lord Stanley's brother, they just showed him being the only one beheaded. When that happened, he kind of said to Henry, like, I don't think you're a fake king, blah, 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 blah. So the head gets chopped off, Arthur kind of turns away, Henry says like, oh, you cannot be a king if you cannot watch a beheading, which, mind you, is so stupid to say to your child. I just think that's so pathetically dumb, my god. Now, during that time, the supposed Richard is getting married to the King of Scotland's niece. Almost all of Europe is there at the wedding. As all that is happening, there's a part with Elizabeth and Henry. They're in the gardens of the palace, and Henry asks Elizabeth, you're not looking at me. Why? Especially after that whole thing with your mother. You haven't been looking at me. What's wrong? What's going on? So Elizabeth decides to tell Henry the day the guards came to get her to take to him, her little brother Richard was with her. Now Henry gets upset with that, and Elizabeth has to tell him, well, here's the thing. We hid him. However, for many years, we've been trying to find him. However, we haven't heard anything. It was completely silent from all across England. No one had seen him or heard of him or anything of that sort. She finally says to Henry, she goes, we had found out that your guards had searched the entire house and slaughtered almost every little boy they could find, and that was when we knew what the silence was about. Richard was dead. So, of course, Henry goes, like, he's dead, and she says yes. And he goes, like, well, okay, if your brother is dead, who the hell is this in Burgundy claiming he's your brother and trying to take my throne? We then see a couple times Elizabeth Dowager Queen getting sicker and just, she's dying. She is essentially going to die in this episode. They're not holding that back. And a couple times Maggie does go to see her, because Elizabeth won't. Elizabeth will not see her mother. But when that happens, Maggie goes to see Elizabeth and tells her what her mother found out about the wedding and said the only country that didn't show up was Spain. So Elizabeth gets the idea of like, well, wait, Spain did not pledge themselves. Maybe they should align with Spain, since Spain did not pledge themselves to, well, the supposed Richard. So she goes and tells Henry Spain did not show up. So then he goes like, well, maybe we should go and pledge ourselves to Spain and try to make an alliance. They have a daughter, we have a son. They go to Spain. Henry and Elizabeth go to Spain. They leave Maggie to watch over Arthur, which she's not happy. She just wants to go home. And also, at that time, Henry's mother, of course, was still grieving over the fact that she killed her beloved Jasper Tudor. And she thinks, oh, God's not talking to me anymore. I've sinned, blah, blah, blah. And that's when the priest dude says to her, or cardinal, says to her, go on a pilgrimage across England. So she goes and she takes, they're calling him Harry, but it's Henry VIII, because she kind of favors him. I don't know why. Henry and Elizabeth go to Spain. They're presented with Catherine dancing, and then they are presented in front of the King and Queen of Spain. Henry doesn't speak Spanish. However, Elizabeth was learning through her sons, because they were learning Spanish, so she could speak to the Queen. Well, the Queen of Spain, she basically was like, well, you have two people besides your husband trying to claim the throne. Get rid of them before we ever let our daughter marry your son, Arthur. But the whole time it's in Spanish, so Henry has no idea what they're saying. So then the Queen says to Elizabeth, tell your husband that it's the Pope we need to get permission from. So Elizabeth tells him the whole Pope idea. And then they go back, but during that time, Richard had made his way to England, and many parts of England started pledging themselves to him. There's a part when Henry's mother and Elizabeth and Henry's son get taken into an abbey for sanctuary so they're safe. And this does play into effect later because Henry's mother does say, like, oh, I'll give you guys a library for being so kind to us. Then they go back. Henry and Elizabeth return home, back to the palace. The family and many of the court members go to the tower for safety. Elizabeth helps Henry get ready for battle. He goes off. Now, during that time, Elizabeth Dowager Queen tries to do a spell to help her son Richard win this fight. However, she kind of fails, and when Henry and his group go into a forest, they think there's someone there, but then they notice there's no one there. There's not an ounce of Richard's supporters or army anywhere. So they think, like, oh, maybe they were too weak to fight us. So he returns home. Elizabeth says, well, he's not a York then if he ran away from a fight. That's not what a York does. They don't run from fights. So, of course, Elizabeth and Henry have their night together, and then, like, the next day, they find out that he didn't run. His wife had their son. So now everybody's like, oh, shit, now he has an heir, and that's going to make his supports stronger, which is bullshit to everybody, at least the Tudors. And they're still alone. They really don't have any support outside of England. And even England, parts of England are going against them. So of course you have to have the second battle. But this time, unfortunately, Elizabeth Dowager Queen dies. Elizabeth does go to see her and whatnot. And even though she was off on the wrong footing with her mother, she didn't want her to die. So she goes to see Henry in the battle, well, in the encampment. And he said to her that even with your letters of writing to these noble people to support me, they didn't show up. They kind of are fleeing. And she says, no, they cannot do this. They are traitors. So she goes off, riding off into the forest, confronts these people and says, you need to pledge yourself. You pledge yourself to a York. I am the eldest daughter of the old York king and now late York queen. Pledge yourself to me and fight for me. They come back, and then Henry, of course, makes a speech saying, like, oh, you'll be honored in the country, your people, your king, and especially your queen. And when he says that, everybody cheers. They go off into a big fight after Elizabeth kind of, you know, kisses him goodbye. They go into a fight. Henry sees Richard is going to try and have a one-on-one duel, which would have been amazing to kind of see, but it doesn't happen because Richard disappears. So Henry gets pissed. They go back. They celebrate because the Tudors won. And then they find out that Richard, along with his wife, had claimed sanctuary in that abbey that Henry's mother and son had taken refuge in. So Henry's mother got the idea of, like, oh, God gave me this pilgrimage to do that. He works in mysterious ways. So she's the only one who can go get him because he can't send an army. She goes to that abbey, gets Richard to come out to take him, and says to the abbey, I know you're doing your job to God, but you'll know more about this sort of stuff when I give you your new library. So she used that library as, like, a leverage on that church, which was kind of interesting, but it played to effect. So now we go on to episode 7, because episode 6 ends there. So now we have episode 7 where Richard is being presented in front of Elizabeth and Henry and whatnot. And he's trying to plead his case that he's the real Richard, but everybody in the court doesn't believe him. And Elizabeth won't even look at him. If she does look at him, she kind of glares at him and gets very upset. So Henry gets the idea, because he knows that if he kills this Richard, half of Europe pledged themselves to him and still parts of England support him. So he figures, if I kill him, I will make a martyr of him, and that will just uprise everybody to come and take my throne. He wasn't going to do that. So instead, he goes, like, I'll make you a servant boy. You will serve me and my wife. As that's going on, Henry's mother is like, we need the wife and their child here to kind of gain even more of like an upper hand. So they are able to get her out of sanctuary by saying like, oh, your husband needs you here. He needs your support, blah, blah, blah. So she comes, her son is taken away, and she becomes one of the ladies in waiting to Elizabeth. During that whole time, Henry thinks he's going to try and get Richard to crack by pretending to make his wife his mistress. But unfortunately, he's also affecting Elizabeth. She's also getting pissed. And at one point, Richard actually starts saying things to Elizabeth that she realizes only her brother would know any of this shit to say to her. She's getting more and more pissed, mind you. At one point during a hunt everybody goes to, Henry starts shooting at Richard. Elizabeth gets a little upset with him for doing that because she is like, that's pretty barbaric to be doing. And then Richard starts saying things to Henry. Henry gets upset. His crown falls off. Richard goes and gets it, holds it there for a second, and then finally gives it back to Henry, which was kind of an interesting scene. So then the hunt ends. In that process, Maggie had gone off to herself, was told a secret message to meet Elizabeth's aunt. Maggie goes sees Margaret, and she tries to devise a plan to get Richard out of there. Maggie, she's iffy. She's not sure. But then after a bunch of crap is happening between Richard and Henry, and even Elizabeth yells at Henry saying, if you're not playing the game, they're playing a much stronger game than you, that's going to rip us apart. And that's not good. So he does slightly back off from that. At one point, they try to get Richard to confess that he's not the real Richard, but he doesn't do it. And they said, like, okay, you're going to do that. We're going to take your son from you and give him to a noble family of the Tudors. And of course, they get upset. Maggie tries talking to him, say, like, we're going to get you. Margaret wants to get you out of here. But Richard's like, I can't do that. My son is still trapped here. And what about my wife? Finally, somewhere in this whole process, Richard reads this fake letter saying who he really is. He's not the real Richard and blah, blah, blah. He contests to it because he wants his son back and he wants his wife to be happy. Well, again, there's a scene during a party where Henry thinks he's been poisoned or something, gets very upset with Richard, drags him off, takes his crown off, and actually smacks Richard in the face with the crown. Holy shit. Elizabeth's yelling at Henry, and then they go down into like the royal wardrobe room. My God, say that 5 times fast. And they beat him up. Elizabeth grabs Henry to get him out of there because he's losing his mind. So Elizabeth's like, Henry, you need to get out of here. So she gets out of there. She says, tend to this boy's wounds. She goes off and talks to Henry and says, you need to get them out of here. They cannot be here anymore. They are ruining us. They are trying to divide us, and this is their plan. We cannot have that happen. So during that, Elizabeth devises a plan to Maggie. After Maggie had told Elizabeth during that whole debacle scene that she figured out that it was Henry's mother who devised her brothers to be dead, so she's going to lose her son. But Elizabeth still won't admit to it because she doesn't want to believe that as a mother. But in that process, she devised a plan to get Richard out of there. And she tells both Richard and his wife, you need to leave. I will try to get your son to you, but you need to go somewhere. Go live in the country or something like that. Leave the country if you have to. Just never come back. Never say your names or something. So she started a fire in the royal wardrobe room. Everything's burning. She thinks that plan worked. They probably got out. She thinks like, oh, if you pretend you're a widow, they'll let you go. But of course, at the very end, the bullshit Richard, my God, comes through the flames like fucking Daenerys in Game of Thrones. And is like, I am Richard. I can walk through fire. God doesn't hate me. And it's just like, oh my God, what are you doing? You had an out, dude. And you fucked it up for you and your family. Oh my God, that was so insane. But I had a feeling it was coming because I was like, he's gonna do some bullshit. And I was right. So the episode ends there. Elizabeth's pissed. So then you have episode 8, which is the finale. It's showing, I think, Richard is going to be executed. I think, from what I gathered from that trailer. I'm not entirely sure, bud. But yeah, that is episode 6 and 7. So when I went through episodes 1 through 5, I was loving the show. I was falling in love with it, for sure. And this time around, with these episodes, so much more happened. You got so much more of the story and development of the characters. Elizabeth was definitely becoming a Tudor queen, that is for sure, and she was deeply in love with Henry now. She is falling in love with him. To rate these episodes, and everything so far with episode 7 included, episode 6, I definitely give a 9 out of 10 stars. It was definitely interesting. Even episode 7, I give a 9 out of 10. And because of that, my rating for the whole series so far, without episode 8, I am definitely rating a 9 to maybe 9.5 out of 10. For sure, because it definitely got better with each episode. It was definitely like The White Queen, where each episode got much better. If I had done a reaction video for episodes 6 and 7, you definitely would have seen me going WTF a lot and questioning a few things, but also some scenes, like, because I know the history of this and I know how things play out, I was very much like, when is this going to appear? When is this gonna happen? There were like scenes that I was like, what is he doing? What is she doing? For sure. There was a part with, I left this out, but there was a part with Maggie when she was carrying Richard to his wife, and I was kind of like, holy shit, the fact that she can actually carry him across the palace. And wait a minute, where the fuck is everybody? Why are they not stopping her? What the hell? But yeah, I'm having a lot of fun with this series so far. So of course, the last episode is episode 8, Old Curses. Of course, in that video, I will be talking about episode 8, reviewing it, and giving my thoughts about not just episode 8, but the entire series altogether. So look forward to that video. But that is it for this video. I will see you all in the next one.